Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas, and you have found a YouTube channel solely dedicated to all things WordPress. Every single Wednesday, I'm producing some sort of video just like this to help you improve your online marketing totally for free. So be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you watch me, you also know that I love Gravity Forms. I have an entire playlist here on our YouTube channel specifically dedicated to all things Gravity Forms. I'll put the link to that in the description box below, so be sure to check that out. Super incredible, easy, fun tips, just like the one you're about to learn today. So how do you actually add an image into a Gravity Form so that people could possibly choose from images? I have a really cool example here for you. Who knew that huge names, well, I knew, but did you know that huge names like Petco uses WordPress? They sure do. This is one of their websites for their Petco Foundation, for their charitable giving. And I want you to check out, when you click donate, you go over here to this really cool process that you can choose from. I want to donate today. And as you scroll down, you have an option to do monthly or one-time giving, right? And then they've got these images sitting in here. Well, I happen to know that this is a Gravity Form that makes this whole process. So I'm gonna show you kind of a way to, well, make this. Let's do it, all right? My example, though, is going to be to have adoption dogs. I want to adopt or have a form where you can choose different dogs to adopt from, but I want the pictures to be there so you fall in love with them. So I've gone over to Unsplash. I don't know if y'all are familiar with this website, but it's royalty-free stock images that you can use, and I grabbed a couple of dog pictures here, and I have uploaded them to my media library. So that's your first step. You need to be sure to have the images ready that you want to use inside of the form, okay? And obviously Gravity Forms is a premium plugin. You have to pay to use it, right? Now I've already created my form for people to fill out their information here. And I want you to see right now kind of what this form looks like. So I'm gonna click preview. So you can just see right now that they've got a couple of fields that they can fill out. But this is really boring, and if I'm wanting to excite somebody about doing something like adopting these dogs, how do I get them excited right here on this form? Check this out, y'all. It's super easy, a little bit of nerd code, but it's super simple to do. Here we go. Inside of the form itself, if I want to have an option that they can only choose one out of however many I put there, I can do radio buttons. If I wanted them to choose multiple options inside of my selections, I could choose check boxes, right? For right now, I'm gonna do radio buttons. So I'm gonna add this to the top of my list. You can, of course, put it anywhere in the order that you wanted to. But for this example, I'm just gonna put it up here. I'm gonna open up the drawer, right? And I'm gonna type in here, select your new best friend, right? Okay. So that's now my instructions. Now here are the options that people can choose from, and right now it just looks like radio buttons, and of course I can have a previously selected one if I wanted to, but you know, I want to have images sitting here. So here's how you do that. Remember I said we need to be sure to have them in our library, right? So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to grab my first image. You want to grab the file name. So that's this. Once you upload it to your media library, you now have a URL of where that file lives on your server. So I'm going to copy that. I copied that onto my clipboard. I'm going to come back over to my form. And here's the little bit of nerd code that you have to write in. If you just put that in there right now as it is, copied and pasted it, this is how it would view. And that's just nerd code sitting there. That doesn't work. So you have to type a little bit of nerd code around it. You do an open angle bracket, the word, the letters IMG for image, SRC for source, equals. You're gonna do open quotes, then you're gonna paste in that file name, in quotes, and end angle bracket, okay? So let me scroll down so you can see this. End quote and end angle bracket, and that closes your nerd code. And check that out. There's our little dog sitting right there. How cool is that? Okay, so this is what the person sees on the front side, but once they select this, you know, I don't know as the owner of this site exactly who they chose. So you can also do this. I'm gonna click show values. And instead of it coming to me saying, hey, they selected our first choice, I actually wanna know exactly who they selected. So I'm gonna type in the name of the dog. Sammy is who they selected. And let's do the next one. Let's go back to our media library. And I'm gonna grab the file path name here, copy it onto my clipboard, open angle bracket, IMG, SRC, equals, open quotes, that's the two of them, paste it in there, in quotes and end angle bracket, and I'm gonna type in Jack. So that's kind of what we're gonna do here. Just keep going through, grabbing each one of them, copying the path, IMG, and this is Lily. And we're gonna do one more here, just for the sake of kind of just showing you the process. Copy that onto my clipboard, IMG, SRC, equals, and this is Pee-wee. Of course it is, right? Yeah. So there are our four beautiful dogs that are available for adoption, and I'm going to click update the form and let you see now what this looks like on the front side of things. Let's preview it. So here are our dogs perfectly, and if I wanted to choose one, you see that the radio button highlights as I click on the image itself. How cool is that, y'all? Oh my word. Well, what if we wanted the names in here too? What if they didn't know that this is Sammy and this is Jack? You can add that. What's cool about Gravity Forms is these lines are nerd code ready. So at the front of our image, if I wanted to put the name up above, I can say Sammy, and then I can just put in a break there, and look at this, the name and then the image. And you can do that all the way down the line here, Jack, and then the BR, which is the line break, and Lily, the BR, it's angle bracket, BR, and then angle bracket, right? Pee-wee is our next dog here. And so now you can see their names up above them. I'm gonna update the form and let you preview it again. And I'm gonna let me click refresh here. Now we have Sammy, Jack, Lily, and Pee-wee. That looks great, huh? I'm gonna show you one last thing before you go, because this is super cool. And if you didn't know this was available, this is about to blow your mind. Gravity Forms actually has CSS ready classes already inside of their style sheet for you. If you didn't know you can do this, you can break things into 3 columns, 2 columns, 4 columns, whatever you want. They've got it preset here. So I'm gonna show you just really quickly what I'm talking about. If I wanted these dogs to be here, like stretched across in 3 columns, or because I have 4, I can say 2 columns, you can actually add again one little line of nerd code. I'm gonna open up the drawer for the one area I want to add into columns. I'm gonna go to this tab for appearance, and inside of the custom CSS, I'm gonna type GF for gravity form. I'm gonna type, this is gonna be list, and we want it in 2 columns. And I'm going to click update, and how I knew that is over here. They've got a whole list of different options. Those are for columns, this is for inline items, this is for a list of items. So you can break them into sections like this. So let me show you what this looks like now as I click refresh. See, now they come in here in these 2 columns. So super cool. Pretty amazing, pretty fun stuff. I'll put the link to the CSS for Gravity Forms in the description box below as well. If you had fun with this, put a comment on the thread here. I'd love to hear from you and see how you're using images inside of your Gravity Forms. I will see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.